Good day and welcome to Mission Control Houston, where flight controllers continue to follow the conduct of the crew of Expedition 29 aboard the International Space Station as it continues to circle the globe at an altitude of about 230 statute miles. All systems on board the International Space Station working very well for this now three-person crew following the recent departure of the three remaining Expedition 28 crew members who landed on the steppe of Kazakhstan last week. With the departure of NASA's Ron Guerin and Russia's Andrei Borisenko and Alexander Samokutyayev, this crew went down to a total size of three and have been spending the weekend getting used to their three-person crew status on board the International Space Station. Of course, the crew is made up of Commander Mike Fossum from NASA, Flight Engineer Satoshi Furukawa from the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, and Sergei Volkov from the Russian Federal Space Agency. Due to the problems with the Progress 44 cargo craft, which was launched during the process of launching the space station on August the 24, the dates of some of the scheduled flights to the International Space Station have changed. That means that this three-person crew will be on board the space station for 61 days before their rest of the Expedition 29 crew members arrive at the space station. That'll be NASA's Dan Burbank and Russia's Anatoly Ivanishin and Anton Shkaplerov, who will be launching from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan on November the 14th and docking with the space station on November the 16th. It'll be a quick handover for the crew members that are going to be going back and forth after that, because it'll be time for Fossum, Furukawa, and Volkov to undock their Soyuz 27 spacecraft on November the 22nd and head back for home after the conclusion of their expedition. On board the International Space Station today, it's been a busy day of experiment work for Mike Fossum, who focused primarily on his work with the VO2 max experiment. That experiment is called the evaluation of maximal oxygen uptake and submaximal estimates of VO2 max before, during, and after long duration International Space Station missions. And the bottom line of that long explanation is they want to see how maximum oxygen uptake works for crew members who exercise on board the International Space Station. Essentially, it requires them to hook themselves up to some sensors, and then they measure their maximum oxygen intake and outgo, as opposed to their normal intake and outgo while they're riding on a stationary bicycle. Now, Fossum had some trouble with the experiment today. He did a full session with VO2 max, and then when he got back with the folks at the payload operations center in Huntsville, Alabama, they told him that for some reason they did not get the data from the bicycle. And he tried again and did a little test, followed all of the switch throws one more time, and the crew in Huntsville agreed that they were getting good data. So we may have to repeat that run, but in any event, Fossum got a good run of exercise on the stationary bicycle. They're required to get about 2.5 hours of exercise each day on the International Space Station to keep their bodies in good shape for the work ahead of them on orbit, as well as to prepare their bodies for the eventual return to one gravity. That kind of exercise helps stave off the potentially detrimental effects in the areas of bone and muscle density loss in particular. In addition to stationary bicycles, they also have advanced resistive exercise device and treadmill equipment on orbit. Coming up later this week for the crew on board the space station, a full group of work for the crew. On Wednesday, they're going to be changing out a router for part of the computer networking equipment to get rid of a problematic docking station that the laptop was linked to. They're going to eliminate that docking station, do that on Wednesday. On Thursday, we're going to have a radio frequency identification scanner test that's going to look at a new way to track items throughout the space station. Thousands of items on the space station, hard to track, and this inventory management system tool is supposed to make that easier. And then Friday, the crew is going to be doing some emergency training for rapid depressurization and some maintenance on the combined operational load-bearing treadmill, or Colbert, to make sure it keeps working well. Of course, the crew just finished their special interactive event with famous scientist and primate researcher Jane Goodall, Dr. Jane Goodall. We're going on to some additional exercise for the crew and additional familiarization with their life as just a three-person crew on orbit. This is Mission Control Houston.